The one consistent bad review about the Cintiq Pro 24 is the fan noise. Now, yes, you can launch the Wacom Center, go to Display Settings Advanced, and change the fan speed. However, for me, after 4 years, my Cintiq's actual hardware broke and the fans ran at full speed all the time for no reason. I can't work with a jet engine up to my ear all day, and without warranty, the cost of shipping and repair is close to $1,000. For that much, may as well buy a new tablet. In this video, I was willing to risk completely breaking my Cintiq. Do not take apart your Cintiq unless you're prepared to take that same risk. This repair video will be more detailed than usual because the tiny amount of info on disassembling a Cintiq Pro 24 is very hard to find. Resources are linked below. I am specifically opening a DTH 2420. The model number matters because the way the case opens and where the screws are hidden is different for each tablet. Before I start, a couple notes. You need a T15 Torx screwdriver to remove the case screws. Use hand tools, not power tools. You need heavy-duty screen opening tools to separate the glass from the case. These tools are plastic, and they're meant to be destroyed in the process. It's normal for them to get chewed up instead of cracking your glass screen, which metal tools will do. Screen opening tools are inexpensive, and you can buy them many places online. Get used to the feel of the power button while assembled, because that'll help you when you put it back together to see if you reseated it correctly or not. There are extremely fine wires connecting the glass screen to the back of the tablet. I did not risk unpinning these, and instead had help holding the delicate electronic sandwich open to disconnect the fans without removing them. This video does not show how to fully separate the tablet pieces, which you will need to do if you plan on completely removing or replacing the fans. I disconnected all 4 fans, and the Cintiq Pro has been totally fine for a year so far. If it dies from overheating, I will pin a comment about that below. The reason I'm testing the fanless lifespan is because I don't use the PC attachment, which would absolutely need fan cooling, and the bigger, hotter Cintiq 27 QHD I used to have, or actually I still have it, but I used that for years and it doesn't have any fans at all. In fact, none of the screen tablets I've used have had a fan until this one. Without the fans, the Cintiq Pro 24 glass screen does get hot at room temperatures of 80 and up. Where I live, that only happens a couple days per year. It was easy to solve a hot screen by running an external fan. I also turn my tablet off when I'm not using it. If you're the type of person that leaves it on 24/7, without fans, the screen might heat up faster and be more annoying. But in general, if you live in a hot climate and your drawing room is regularly hellish, I would be pessimistic about the tablet's overall lifespan without any internal fans. Alright, let's get started. Unplug everything. Lay the Cintiq flat on a towel, padded tablecloth, or other semi-soft surface. Pop off the back cover. Finish removing any cables and the dongle if you haven't yet. Remove the bottom cover. It's clipped on hard. Rather than prying, it's easier to pop it up by sticking the plastic tool handle into the vent near each corner. Twist. After the corners are free, run your fingers under the edge and pull it up. Lift the tablet legs, remove 2 long screws under the legs, the 4 screws along the top, and the 6 screws that were hidden by the bottom cover. Be careful with the bottom screws, pressing down hard can damage the electronics underneath. You do not need to remove the cable clips. These don't attach to anything else, so it's safe to leave them in. Next, we're going to separate the glass from the case. Turn the tablet around so the power button faces you. Move up to the corner away from it. Starting at that corner, insert the plastic tool into the straight part of the seam between the glass and the case. Move along the seam, wiggling the tool to get the clips inside to pop. It will take some force to get started and move along the seam.
It's difficult right there. I wonder if I can get around this curve.
No, you got it. Yeah, it's up there. Be very careful of the power button area. This is the number one area that breaks for people during repairs. So that is actually attached to the screen, and I can't see like the solder points, but that will break if you twist. See how it's, yeah. So that's the part you're most likely to break. After reassembly, we had to take the screen off again to reseat the power button because it wasn't quite in the right spot and wouldn't turn the tablet on. Once the screen's unclipped, you have two options. Either carefully lift it partway open to disconnect all wires holding the halves together and hope that you can plug those tiny pins back in, or continue without disconnecting anything and just hold the halves partially open, which is what I'm going to do. If you're working alone, you can use a couch to support the tablet while it stands up. Now that it's open, you might be able to see any obvious fan problems.
It's not really clogged in a way that would be causing whatever's happening, a sensor issue. Like, we could try blowing them out, but I honestly don't think that's gonna... I don't think that's a problem. I think it's a sensor problem somewhere.
If all you want to do is disconnect the fans, reach in, follow the trail of red, blue, yellow wires, and unplug the end of that cable from the board. You have to do this for each of the fans you want to shut off, and there are four in total. Three connect to the central board, one connects to the sideboard.
I might want to put a piece of electrical tape just over that, just in case it doesn't flop around and arc on anywhere. The fan itself is not powered, but if I get two points together, that could possibly cause an arc. I don't want that to happen.
All right, so we'll put electric tape on that. All right, well, let's put it back together. This is the hard part, by the way. I've heard putting it back together is where we're gonna like snap the power, that little tiny power button off or something like that. So,
well, yeah.
Yeah, let's do it. Carefully lower the tablet back down and make sure your power button is in the right place. Moving along the edges, push the screen back into the case. You'll hear the clips snap. Put the screws back in. And now, before you put the covers back on, try plugging the tablet in and seeing if it powers on. If it doesn't, feel your power button. Is it depressing completely? If not, unscrew everything, take the screen off, and try again. If it still won't go, even though you're sure your power switch is in the right place, you could try powering it on manually. Press the button directly while the tablet is apart. If that doesn't work, something broke, and now you have a huge problem that's going to take a real repair person to fix. If you can't figure it out yourself. But otherwise, if all you did was unplug fans, once the tablet is reassembled and hooked back up, you should be good to go. And I can't believe how quiet the Cintiq is now. Have you had any fan or tablet problems? Tell me about them below, and let me know if you fixed it at home or if the whole thing turned into just a big disaster.